Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
So when Jacob is saying, what will befall you in the last days? You know, the question comes to mind then, so when is the last days? Right? In Genesis 49, when this is written, it's well over 2,000 years. The earth had been around for about 2,000 years. Right? When Jesus was talking to them in Matthew 24, the earth had been around for well over 4,000 years. And today, in America, right now, this morning, the earth has been around for well over 6,000 years. And, you know, I believe, according to the scriptures, that the end times began with the first coming of Christ. I believe the signs that they were looking for was the coming of Christ, and yet it will be completed with the last coming. And obviously, we still have the millennium and the new heaven, new earth, the total end, all those things will still play out. And so in Matthew 24, at his first coming, he's telling them of the second coming. And I believe during that first coming, that was the beginning. That's when the end times actually began. So, you know, in Acts chapter 1, as Jesus is preaching to his disciples, right before he ascends to heaven, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? So, of course, they're saying, okay, Lord, now you've fulfilled your earthly ministry. He's about to ascend into heaven. And what are they asking? Well, what about the judgment of the earth? Right? What about the establishment of your kingdom? What about this dominion that will last forever come about? Right? So the end times must include these details. The disciples knew about it from the Old Testament, anticipating it. Now, I want you to hold your place in Genesis 49. Turn to Malachi chapter 4. Malachi chapter 4. That's the very last book in the Old Testament, right before Matthew in the New Testament. And again, I believe that it's from the first coming to the second, and obviously there are things fulfilled at the second with the millennial reign and that sort of thing. In Romans 11, it says that blindness in part has happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles come in. He's saying that God was working through a physical nation, but you know, that physical nation, they weren't all saved. There was the spiritual nation inside of that physical nation. Well, God has broken down those barriers. He's made it clear the gospel's out to the Gentiles. He goes on, he says, and so all Israel shall be saved. As it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer. Right? Jesus has came out of the Zion. Jesus will come back to Zion. So that's partially fulfilled. There's more yet to come. And you know, he will return. So it's the first and the second work together. And in Luke chapter 21, which is a parallel to Matthew 24 that we just read, he says, "In Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled." Jesus telling them, hey, when will this happen? Hey, when I come back a second time. Right? So what are the end times? I believe that we have a period called the end times that start at Jesus' his first coming. And they begin to end at the second coming. Obviously, at his second coming and the resurrection, there are still things that play out before the end of the world. So that's not the total end. There's still things that God does there. But he tells us clearly that the time of the Gentiles, that's when it will be fulfilled. That's when everything will happen that he spoke about. So when Jacob speaks of what's going to happen in the last times, the things he's talking about are in a pretty big boundary of several thousand years. Do you see? So people don't always get that. In Matthew 11, Jesus said, and from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violent take it by force. For all the prophets in the law prophesied until John, and if you will receive it, this is Elias, which was to come. Right? He's saying, hey, this is Elias. This is that Elijah. In 1 Peter 1, Jesus Christ was manifest for us in these last times. When was Jesus Christ manifest in the flesh? At his first coming, right? Beginning the last times. Look, you're in Malachi chapter 4. So we see that we have the Old Testament, we have the New Testament, where we, you know, he's clearly telling us the last days come at his first coming. Look at verse number 5. Malachi chapter 4, verse number 5. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children, and from the heart of the children to their fathers, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse. So Jesus is saying, before all these things are fulfilled, you're going to see Elijah coming, right, preparing the way, he talks about in other chapters. Go ahead and go back to Genesis 49. Genesis chapter 49. So Jesus, from Genesis to Malachi from the beginning and end of the Old Testament, he's giving us signs and warnings about the end of the world, about his coming as a savior and also as a king.